She calls me Chechi. It means elder sister, but has expanded to incorporate blanket hogger, ice cream stealer, unfair monopoly player, Chechi in both derision and delight. Chechi followed by an endless march of questions. It is a question that marks our first act of conspiracy. Chechi, what is a crush? Chechi, what is a crush? And I remember feeling both mirth and mortification, because how do you explain the difference between love and infatuation and the terrible difference between the two to a 6-year-old and assure her that it's okay if you can't not understand just yet, because you're 13 years old and you don't understand just yet. And over the years, the frequency of these questions ebb and rise, wax and wane, but they never cease. They never cease. They prick me. They egg my discomfort. They egg my discomfort, making me want to itch something. So, over the years, my sister picks up on my defenses, my bite and anger, my snap and dodge, my erratic, ever-shifting threshold of impropriety, where one week I gorily, gleefully tell her what periods are, and then the next I throw a fit when she asks me what a virgin is. The questions never cease, but they slow down to a trickle. I begin to recognize this sinister system that winks with one eye and then shuts the other, feigning a blindness far more crass than what it seeks to censor. A plea of ignorance that perpetrates more than lets children deal in dubious knowledge in cleared histories and incognito browsers, in pseudo-sex ed, taught by giggling eavesdroppers. Epiphany, I make a policy decision. No more. No more should my sister feel perverse, ashamed, or unentitled to anyone's honesty. And the best policy decisions aren't supposed to be easy, they're supposed to be right. Because, full stop, or because I said so, or wait till the 8th grade, should never be how I answer a question. It might be, I don't know right now, but I'm going to find out and tell you, or I'm not sure you're going to understand, but here's what I can explain. But every answer must be wrenched from my gut and dropped by my mind, because, hyphen, when a man and woman don't love each other, they can still have babies. Because when I asked my sister, jigsawed beneath blankets, her hair scratching my chin, my heartbeat, her metronome, her lullaby, who's your hero? She said my name, and she said it simply, and I lay awake while she fell asleep, wondering how my name didn't just buck to its knees with the weight she had given it. Heroes should tell you that not knowing is not a failing. Heroes should tell you that curiosity exists for its own reason, that an innocent act of questioning doesn't make you smaller, and a careless refusal of answering doesn't make you bigger. Heroes should tell you that it's the other way around. My first test of conviction knocks on the door in her PT uniform, undone plaits and dripping sweat. Chechi, what does balls mean? She doesn't whisper it, but she eyes me warily, you know, to take balls. She repeats clearer, and she doesn't whisper it. So I don't either. I explain the correlation, the colloquial correlation between male genitalia and the virtue of bravery. Also, how our particular testicular lack does not exclude us, how it's gender neutral. Not like Romero or Bigham or even Hero. Context. It takes balls to stand up to your friends, to admit you are wrong, to ask a question when you think you might get yelled at. And I watch as my sister walks out the door in her PT uniform, undone plaits and dripping sweat right down her giant swinging balls. Supreme authorities, their opinions aren't more valid than yours or your friends or the internet. They'll tell you to never stop learning or inquiring or discovering, that the universe is infinite outwards and your mind is infinite inwards, and to fetch the goddamn shit. Hammering at you with good intentions until you're so sick of it, you ask if they're ever going to stop, to which your hero will answer truthfully, nope, never. Whoa!